Wouldn't it be weird if one day in the future you were buying a home and the listing said, batteries not included? Yeah, well, that could totally happen. Hey there, people. Julian here for DNews. Electricity is pretty great. It powers my toaster, my fridge, my hairdryer, my air conditioner, my humidifier, my dehumidifier, and my PC that I use to watch science YouTube videos. I think I'm gonna keep using it. The problem is, everyone in all the other houses feels the same way, usually at about the same times of day, and they're driving the cost of those tasty kilowatts up in the evening. Of course, during the day, if you don't want to use power from the grid, you could get some solar panels and harvest sunlight, but that's not helpful when the sun's down, also known as nighttime, also known as the time I need to have electricity to turn lights on to not bang my shins on all the furniture. Enter the battery-powered home. The idea is a rechargeable battery stores energy from solar panels during the day or from off-peak hours when grid energy is cheapest and uses that energy during the rest of the day. The problem is, if you've ever bought batteries, you know they cost approximately one arm and or one leg. Elon Musk thought that this was a silly hang-up for what is otherwise a great idea and decided to do something about it. Elon Musk, for y'all that don't know, is basically what would happen if Tony Stark lost the goatee. His interests range from online money movement to commercial spaceflight to, most importantly for this topic, electric cars. His company, Tesla Motors, has been refining electric car batteries for years, engineering them to be lighter, longer lasting, and more efficient. So why don't we take all those batteries and put them on a wall? So they did that. The Tesla Powerwall is basically a bunch of lithium-ion cells in a sleek case. They're compartmentalized and liquid-cooled to solve the knotty problem of overheating and burning your house down, something that is generally undesirable. If you wanted it as your main power supply, there's a model that can store and discharge up to 7 kilowatt hours daily and costs $3,000. Best of all, it should last 10 years, which is approximately 8 years longer than my laptop battery made it before it couldn't hold a charge anymore. The trick to this longevity is how much power it outputs. It's only pumping out 2 kilowatts continuously, and peak output is 3.3 kilowatts. The problem that then arises is some appliances will use more than that output. An electric clothes dryer could draw that much power on its own. So if you want to dry clothes, I hope you weren't planning on microwaving a burrito too. If you wanted to not be reliant on the grid at all, you'd probably need a few power walls to go with your solar panel roof. Depending on where you live, your power consumption can vary widely, but the average US home in 2011 used 940 kilowatt hours per month. A solar setup of that size would cost over $11,000, not including installation or taking tax credits into account. Then you'd need 5 power walls to store all of that sunshine juice, so that's another 15 grand. It's an expensive prospect right now, but as the cost of batteries and solar panels continue to drop, individual homes that are independently powered could become a great way to kick our fossil fuel habit. Inexpensive home batteries are looking like a promising innovation. They're not the only company innovating. Intel creates breakthrough technologies that make amazing experiences possible. Having Intel inside makes for better experiences outside. Intel drives innovation with products like processors, wearables, and IoT devices, and within data centers, in the PC and beyond. Going green sounds like a lot of effort. Is it really worth it? Trace explains why, yes, totally it is, right here.
Once you build a solar array and fields of wind turbines, those renewable energy sources start to cannibalize the power generation needs of the traditional power plants.
Would you use the Powerwall? Would it be like a supplement for your energy use, or would you go all out and be energy independent? Let us know in the comments, subscribe, and I'll see you next time on DNews.